everyone, this is Germany Kent, and I'm here at the Hollywood Tribute Awards, and we are checking out some great fashions here on the red carpet, and also celebrities and everybody else who's rolling through with their Oscar predictions. You do not want to miss this. Stay tuned. Guys, this is Germany on the red carpet at the Hollywood Tribute Awards, and I have caught up with the amazing Keith L. Craig, and for those of you who don't know him, he is the reason why Black Panther got to be the success that it is, and also he's behind The Lion King and a lot of other Disney phenomenons, I'm going to say. This guy's a genius, but look, that's enough of me talking about him. I'm going to let him brag on himself. Talk to us more about just your platform and just how you feel to be the amazing person behind such great films that we've seen.
Well, first of all, it's a team effort at distribution, so it's a lot of strategy behind the scene and planning, whatever, you know what I'm saying, for the most part, understanding the DMA, demographic market areas that each particular film is going to reach. And just pretty much, you know, what people appeals to what film. So that's kind of what we put that into that, you know.
Do you love working for Disney? Like, I used to intern for Disney. That was my first job. A lot of people don't know that. Yes, I was a tour guide at the Great Movie Ride. But I loved working for Disney. It's a powerhouse company. So talk to me more about just working for Disney.
Well, you know, coming from the military, I was with the number one military in the world. So now I'm in the with the number one media company in the world. So it's a great, you know, just a lifetime achievement to be there working with such a phenomenal company that takes great care of their people. You know, so just happy to be there.
Who's some of your favorite contenders for tonight?
Well, again, being a military guy, 1917 is the movie that I'm really pulling for because it's kind of near dear to my heart, you know.
A lot of people have been talking about 1917. What's your pick for best actress?
I don't want to say. So I'm going to stay neutral on that one.
Okay. So and no, none of the acting categories. I see in your eyes, like, don't put me on the spot with that.
No.
Okay, what about your best moment for the Oscar season thus far?
Just being around, meeting great people, you know what I'm saying? I'm a people's person, I love people, so just meeting new people such as yourself and being able to interact with people and see their excitement about, you know, this experience. So many people won't want to experience this ever in a lifetime, so
right.
I'm very excited about that.
And when you talk about experiencing something once in a lifetime, just because it's a season that we're in right now, I have to ask you about the life of a legend that we just lost, and that's Kobe Bryant. Do you have any feelings on his life, his legacy?
Oh, absolutely. Kobe, I'm hoping that they take Kobe Bryant, they take the NBA silhouette, that's Jerry West, and replace it with Kobe Bryant. Because I admire Kobe for, you know, all the resilience he showed. And also as a family man, I love the way that he took care of his daughters, started the academy, he became a philanthropist, you know what I'm saying? Probably misunderstood because he was very protective, but yeah, I'm a huge fan of Kobe Bryant, so I think all of us should just be proud that he was, you know, an African-American hero.
Absolutely. Thank you, Keith.
Thank you so much.
All right.
Thank you so much.
Okay.